My name is Harshvardhan Chaturvedi and I am a legal intern at Lexis and Company. So today we are going to talk about Juvenile Justice Board. Under the Juvenile Justice Act 2015, a board shall consist of Metropolitan Magistrate or a Chief Judicial Magistrate with at least 3 years experience and 2 social workers selected in such a manner as they may prescribe, of whom at least one shall be a woman. The powers and functions of the board are ensuring the informed participation of the child and the parent or guardian in the every step of the process, ensuring that the child's rights are protected throughout the process of apprehending the child, inquiry, aftercare and rehabilitation, ensuring availability of legal aid for the child through the legal service institutions. Wherever necessary, the board shall provide an interpreter or translator having such qualification, experience, and on payment of such fees may be prescribed to the child if he fails to understand the language used in proceedings. Directing the probation officer, or in case probation officer is not available to the child welfare officer or a social worker, to undertake a social investigation into the case and submit social investigation report with a period of 15 days from the date of first production before the board to ascertain circumstances in which the alleged offence was committed. Adjudicate and dispose of case of children in conflict with law in accordance with the process of inquiry. Transferring to the committee matters concerning child alleged to be conflict with law, stated to be in need of care and protection at any stage, thereby recognizing that a child in conflict with law can also be a child in need of care. Simultaneously, there is need for the committee and the board to be both involved. Disposing of the matter and passing a final order that includes an individual care plan for the child's rehabilitation, including follow-up by the probation officer or the district child protection unit. Conducting inquiry for declaring fit persons regarding care of fit children in conflict with law. Conducting at least one inspection visit every month of residential facilities for children in conflict with the law and recommend actions for improvement in the quality of services to the district child protection unit and the state government. Order the police for registration first information report for offenses committed against any child conflict with law under this act or any other law for the time being in force on a complaint made in this regard. Order the police for registration first information report for offences committed against any child need of care and protection under this act or any other law time being in force on a written complaint by a committee in this regard. Conducting regular inspection of jails meant for adults to check if any child is lodged in such jails and take immediate measures for transfer such child to the observation home. Thank you.